Let's talk a bit more about 2020 this week. Why not? Horrible things should always be talked about, I guess. Have you noticed that some things are missing? You said no? Maybe it's because you're still at home. But you said yes. I can't tell. So here's some things that we've noticed we're missing. The state fair. All of those crazy rides, games, funnel cakes. Oh, I love the funnel cakes. Why'd you have to take them away? Why have you left me? Sorry. They're all gone. Just gone. No thanks to you, COVID. Colleges like UNC and others being canceled in person? Okay, most of you probably aren't in college yet, but you will be one day. Just hope that on that day, when you become a freshman, that UNC or other colleges will come back. Oh, hey, was that your older brother? Oh no, he came home early, and now you're stopping him. Last but definitely not least, college football. That has to be a nightmare. Somebody wake me up. Okay, this can't be right. College football was canceled? But I had a whole night planned of me and all my bros getting together and everything, and I would get some nachos and we'd all binge together and we would yell at the TV together and get angry and say, "Ref, you're terrible." So all of those extra nachos that I bought, oh well, I can still eat them by myself. Take that, 2020. I wouldn't be surprised if there was anything else. What do you see that's missing? No, wait, don't tell me. Aliens? Dude, we already talked about that last time. Pizza? Yeah, we already said that too. Beards? You know what? I'm done. Bye. Plus, beards will always be relevant. Goodbye again! What is up, students? How you doing?
Yeah.
Tell us right now in the comments. I want to know how you're doing today.
Dan, I am doing great, Mark. Thanks for asking.
I was actually not going to ask you. I was going to say Dan wants to know too. But Dan, how are you doing? How you doing, man?
So I would like to know too, students, what you are doing and how you are doing. See how we did that, Mark? We switched the conversation. See how we did that? But
I wanted to know first, so that matters. Good. Stevon, how are you doing, man? How's your week been, bro?
I'm hanging in there, man. You guys are helping. You're actually doing some good job.
We're doing it?
I hope good work so. Here. You're doing a good job. Thank you, guys.
I don't know. I'm just going to cover both. Anyway, that was
good awkward. Enough.
Students, we are so glad that you're back so that we don't have to be awkward by ourselves, because left alone to our own devices, we're terrible. But this is an important night that you're joining us, because we have so much to say. We got some important guests later, but first of all, huh?
So much. Let's just whisper the rest of the show. Yeah.
Anyway,
I'm fully on board with this idea.
No whispering. I'm about to get angry.
No.
It's about to happen. Guys, I'm always in a great mood, and then we start the show, then something happens. I think I need psychological and professional help, but that's too expensive, and I work for a church. So, anyway, there's one thing that has been bothering me lately, and it's my deodorant. It smells good. It works fine. I personally, I don't know about you guys, but I'm an Old Spice guy myself, and I appreciate all the scents of antiperspirant and deodorant combinations. Like, I can still smell like fresh.
The woodsy smell.
I don't like it.
And that's just my natural juice.
Everyone stop, but smell your armpits.
Do it right now. Smell your armpits. Let us know in the comments how it is.
Scale of 1 to 10, how much they stink. 10 is really bad, 1 is perfect.
Woodsy, cheesy, or does it smell like sweaty socks?
Anyway. Drop an emoji in the comments of the smell of your armpits. Let's go.
That's it.
Go, drop.
So here's the deal. But sometimes, I love my deodorant, but sometimes I accidentally pick up the deodorant that is not a deodorant and antiperspirant combination. Mm. And therefore, I feel insecure through the rest of my day. Am I going to deodorize only or be smelling good also? I don't know. Am I going to make it through the day? Also, here's what really makes me angry, but this is also a good thing. There are way too many flavors/scents of deodorant.
Well, I mean, if you get three, like, so you're tasting, you're licking your deodorant?
Well, when I'm out of toothpaste,
So, man, I have a lot of issues. Anyway, so there's just way too many scents of deodorants. Like right now, I'm currently rocking Yeti Frost by Old Spice, but I'm partial to Bear Glove by Old Spice. But I can't just decide which one I want, so I'm really, really overwhelmed. And here's the last thing I'm going to say. Sometimes deodorant makes me mad because when I'm out of my Bear Glove or Yeti Frost, I have accidentally grabbed my wife's Secret Just for Women deodorant. And I'm bearing my soul right now.
It's okay.
I don't know what I have done. And I didn't tell her because I felt guilty.
You can't tell her because you got your armpit hair in there. Like she's rubbing her armpit with your armpit hair, man.
I mean, we're married, but whatever. Two have become one, but that's a little too much.
But
you know who I blame this on, Dan? Stefan? 2020! I blame you.
I would.
And I'm also angry that the Hurricanes lost stupid Bruins, so whatever.
So if you're watching this right now and you agree with what Mark said, you should like the video. Also, share this video tonight because we got a really great show coming up.
Yes, we do.
Right, Mark? Like what?
Yes, because we have so much more in store tonight. Hint, here's your hint. Sour is our enemy on the Eat Challenge tonight. Oh, I'm not looking forward to it.
Not ready for it. Not ready
for it. Also, based on our Eat Challenge, we're going to have another reaction of the week for you tonight. So to look out for that. It's going to be great. And this week on the internet is so good. And I really want to show it to you, but I cannot until what, Stevon? I can't show them until they do what?
Until you join us for our Easter Egg Challenge. It's happening every week. And we have some amazing winners that have been winning this challenge, and you don't want to miss out. It could be you. There's going to be an easy way for you to be a part of this actual challenge and game. So if you've never played it before and it's your first time here, welcome to the crazy Crossroads Student Show. The way it works is you will see objects on the screen. They'll be flashing really quickly, and the first person to drop the object emoji in the chat will win a prize. It may be one, it may be two, maybe three, maybe 100. You never know. So be on the lookout.
And I'm going to say this. If you drop the emoji and you win, but your name on YouTube isn't your real name, we don't know who you are. So you need to, when you win, drop your real name in the comments so we know who to give the prize to.
Please.
When you win.
That's a nice alliteration.
When you win
also,
or win.
Also, comment on the side. Like the video, share this now, because we about to do comment of the week. But before we do that, I want you to take a moment, assess your life, and then share this video. Here's your moment.
Assess your life. What?
You did it. Shall we do a comment of the week, guys?
Let's do it. Let's go.
Comment of the week.
Ooh, so many great comments.
Oh, man. Yeah. You know, students, right now, I just got to give you some recognition and honor because you guys have great comments. Some of them scare me a little bit, but that's why they're so awesome. A lot of them are really deep. Here's something that Grace told us. And she says this, Grace C on the tube. She says, some of my friends don't believe in Christ. Last week we talked about sharing your faith and taking those steps. She said, some of my friends don't believe in Christ and it makes me sad. I've tried to talk to them before, but some of them say I don't care or did I ask? So she's got a great concern. Grace, keep doing it. Keep plugging away. Get around a community of friends like yourself and keep pushing.
Yes, please do. Second comment of the week is from Anna Vader. And it says, my parents are coming home and I have to do the dishes. But no, I will watch this later, Mark. You're doing a great job over there at Wake Forest, Mark.
Go, Anna.
And watching our show.
Because the beauty of YouTube is you can watch this after it's done because it just stays on YouTube. You can keep watching YouTube. Yes. So share this because even if they can't get it here tonight, they can still watch it later. My comment. So we were hanging out before the show this last week, like 10 minutes before we went live. And there was a few students chatting away. And one of them dropped a comment. I was like, watch you be on the show this week. Zoe Z. You always wanted to be on the comment of the week, but you're not funny. Guess what? You don't need to be funny. You just got to be present, and we throw you up here and recognize you. Thank you, Zoe Z.
Yeah!
Awesome.
Come on.
Got a little excited there.
Drop some comments. Make us laugh. They don't have to be funny. They just have to be you, and if we see you, we're adding you to the show. Let's go.
It's all about engagement. Come on, engage with us.
Can we not do Eat this week?
Dan, I'm going to answer that. And you know what? Because I feel your concern, I'm going to answer that with, we cannot not do it.
Wow.
Whew. Okay, so what are we doing, Mark? Right. What are we eating this week?
So I'm excited and not excited about this. Full disclosure, I had a big lunch, and it was some spicy hot tacos from Chipotle. Mm, so I don't know what we're going to eat.
Can we eat that next week?
Let's just do that.
Let's eat real food.
Hey, you tell us in the comments. Come on, this is your opportunity. Yes, no.
Don't say something stupid. If you say
drop a taco,
frog legs or spicy chicken McNugget spleens, no.
No, we're done.
Anyway, tonight, you know, this thing is not just for summer anymore. The lemon is for all year round. So we are doing the lemon challenge tonight. And here's the parameters. Here's the rules. We'll have a 30-second timer come up. And during that 30 seconds, we are going to do two things. One, we're going to eat as many. I almost said we're going to meet. We're going to eat as many of these lemon
laces.
Pieces, slices as possible. And then after that, we're going to chug the last 10 seconds. We're going to chug as much of our lemon juice as possible. I got the Food Lion brand because
I'm poor. Make sure you shake it up. Make sure you shake it up.
Oh, yeah. Well before using, I think. So, guys, here's the other thing to add to this. Remember this, Steve-On and Daniel. Spilled everywhere.
Students, we're doing this for you.
Yes, remember that, but also Dan and Steve-On. Here's the thing. Students, you're playing in this too. So Dan and I and Steve-On, we have to not show facial expressions. We have to just not let it bother us. And so whoever cracks first will lose. So students,
what do we lose?
Dignity, respect, street cred, whatever. Wow. So students, in the comments, you need to tell us who has smiled or cracked or broken a blank stare the most, because that person will then have to have some kind of punishment. And let us know what the punishment is, because honestly, I have no idea.
Yeah.
Are we ready, fellas? Get your first lemon. So this is speed and seriousness. And at 10 seconds left, I'm going to yell and say, chug. You ready?
And always face the camera.
Are you ready?
Ridiculousness.
I'm going to drip. So that's why this is here, for the dripping.
Oh.
Three.
Oh, dear God.
Two.
I already feel it.
One, go.
Oh.
Mm. Yeah, that's real good.
Sour. I felt that. That was real.
Not a fan of what's happening.
Not a fan of
10 seconds, chug.
You get a beard.
Chug. Chug.
Oh, shit.
Whoa.
Oh, it just hurt. Nope. Oh, that's it. That's it. Time.
Oh, I need my mommy.
Time.
Oh. Watch it off. Wash it down.
Time. Stop
it. Wash it down with what?
With the lemon juice.
I already did that. You know what?
This is incredibly bitter.
Oh, yeah.
So cringy.
It tastes like the aftertaste of
everything.
Like, you vomit when you're sick, it tastes like the aftertaste of that in your mouth.
I got through like 2/3 of a lemon in the time.
I got 3 pieces left, so.
I am warm all over.
Of one lemon or of all the lemons? I feel like my lips are like puffing up.
My goal was to eat this whole thing and I got through 4, maybe.
Can you be allergic to lemons? I might be allergic to lemons.
We're about to find out. That's not good.
What's happening to my lips?
You're freaking out.
Here we go. This week on the internet. Here we go.
Dude gonna fall when he get up.
Look at him! He can't get up! Dava, dava, up! DJ!
is my baby.
I am?
And ain't nobody finna touch
me. I ain't no baby.
My life be like, ooh, yeah, ooh. My life be like,
Mama, chip away my heart.
Now, now!
Mom, I caught a seagull.
Smack came.
What's going on here? You are not Mark and Steve Vaughn. What
I am
is going?
Steve,
no, you are not. Where is Mark's beard? Who are you people?
Usher.
Tell me.
Dan, you know us.
I don't.
Me, Anna.
Been texting me all week.
You know,
I'm expecting
Anna?
A paycheck.
We go to your church.
Anna.
We go to your church.
Naomi.
Naomi.
I did theater a lot.
What's with the hands? Is this? Do I look more theatric now?
No.
Just hands.
Yeah. Just hands. Nonsense, so, know? One at a time, please introduce yourself because I'm confused. Anna, who are you?
Okay. Anna, senior. You've known me for almost a year now, and I have a weird obsession with dogs. I don't know, categorize me that way.
Why dogs? Okay, whatever. I'm gonna go next. I'm Joel. Dan, you've known me for a long time.
Hi,
you've been texting me. I'm expecting a paycheck about this soon.
Do we bury a ball at one point?
I'm gonna be the next Johnny Depp, you know? People say I look like him, so that's me.
You've gotta know me. I've known you since like you first came to Crossroads. Like, Naomi, I do theater a lot, I did Sound of Music.
The jazz.
It's a lot of fun. You know who I am.
I know.
Come
you.
On.
I know you. Next.
I'm gonna be honest. I don't know you that well, but I know Mark because he's pretty cool. So.
So. Yeah. What's your name, though?
My name.
Your
my
name.
My name's Hunter.
Hunter. What grade are you in, Hunter?
I'm in 10th grade.
Cool.
Yeah.
So, first question: who's growing the beard out? Because we need a beard. Show of hands: who's growing the beard?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure. I raised my hand really fast.
If one of you come to this show with a beard on, perfect, Naomi, perfect. So students, as you can see, the screen looks different right now. Here's what's happening. As you many of you may be aware, you might not be, this morning we did church live in students. We had Wake Forest, we had Millbrook students live, both RSVP'd. RSVPs filled up, which is incredible, but that means the show is shifting a little bit because we want to have students be the primary voices in student ministry. I know it's a crazy idea. I know. But so Anna, Joel, Naomi, and Hunter are actually going to be joining us every single week on the show to add their voices to the conversation. The show is going to shift. We're going to be providing. Yes, take a bow. Worth it. The show is shifting a little bit to be student-centered, student-focused. We'll be taking content from Sunday and sharing it with you here on YouTube. And these students, along with me, Mark and Steve Vaughn, will be engaging with you here. So every week, 7 p.m., shows staying the same. New faces joining the team. Drop emojis in the... What emojis should they drop in the comment?
The one with, like, the money tongue. And the, like,
you're
the
not
money
getting paid. Signs. Stop it. What other emoji should they drop in the comments?
The bacon and the fire.
Smiley face.
Because bacon is fire and students are fire. And bacon is good and students are good. So, you know, you get the correlation.
I like yes. it.
Not really.
Dan, she's calling you bacon.
I don't know if that's a good thing or not, so I'm going to take it as a good thing.
Yeah.
Which is it better to be called Bacon or Johnny Depp?
Bacon?
Johnny Depp.
Johnny Depp.
Are you calling Johnny Depp or saying star Johnny Depp? Because that's a big difference.
I've just gotten confused, which is a wonderful thing. So before I start like screaming at a wall, can we talk about this morning church? So this morning we had started a brand new series, In Person, Next Is Now. And we looked at how living now is what matters. The choices that you make, the mindsets that you have allow you to really step into next in a healthy, positive way. We talked about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego as a primary story. And students, if you haven't read that, Book of Daniel, chapter 1, 2, 3, check it out, read it. We're gonna talk about it tonight. But tonight I wanna just kind of have a discussion around it that students can engage with in the comments and things like that. Anna, can I ask you a question? Can I start with you and ask you a question?
Go for it.
What has been one of the biggest challenges, not just for you, but for you students like you during this season of COVID?
I think that probably the biggest challenge would be community and physical touch, because it's been proven that us as humans, and especially as Christians, we need a community. And like having 8 hugs a day is considered
dangerous.
Oh, leave. I'm doing something.
Get off the show.
It's dangerous.
Just go ahead and give me a hug.
8 hugs is dangerous.
So you need 8 hugs a day to keep what is considered maintenance, like your mental health. So it's good for people who are being hugged and people who are hugging. And I think that if you don't get that through just FaceTime or Skype or Zoom or whatever else.
So good. Joel, what do you think?
I think one of the hardest, at least in my experience, has been physical outlets. Like I used to play lots of sports, and I know all of the people's sports have been taken away. So definitely a struggle this quarantine, I guess, is finding how to stay physically active, because I like video games and that's not physically active.
You sit around. Anybody else play video games here tonight? Anybody else in the comments? What games do you play? Let us know. Naomi, a little bit. Naomi, what do you think? What's one of the biggest challenges of the last few months for students like you?
I mean, I would have to agree with Anna, like just not being with like our friends and in our community and getting to see each other. It's like really hard because we see each other all the time and then suddenly we just can't see each other and we can't hug and we can't have fun and go out. And it's just, it's horrible.
Yeah. Yeah. It's so true. Hunter, what do you want to add to this idea?
Yeah. Kind of what they're all saying. I'm a big people person. I need to be around people that basically function, and it's really hard, but I know I can stay safe, but it's really challenging not being able to talk to people, because that's just what I need. I need people to be good, so it's been really hard.
Yeah, and that community is such a need right now in this season. I think every student watching this right now would admit, if they answer the question, what do you need most right now? They would say community, friendship, to be around people, something around that idea. So how can you even fight for a community during the season? Because the need hasn't changed, but the tools have. So what ways have you been fighting for community up to now? And even over the next few weeks, what ideas do you have that you could share with students right now? Anna, what do you think?
I think personally what I've been doing, and what I would suggest for other people to be doing, is keeping up with people through Instagram. Even though it won't fulfill the need of like touch, it will definitely, you'll be a part of their lives in some way. Daily checks with your friends that you haven't seen in a while. Me and my friends have been doing sleepovers, like over the phone, like having a movie marathon at night. Like a FaceTime movie marathon. So you have the same snacks and they have the same snacks, and you're sitting both with your phone set up like this, and you're watching the same movie at the same time, and you just mute, and then every time you want to talk, you unmute.
So
it's one way to have community.
Never would have thought of that. I love students and how you have figured out community. Joel, what do we do to fight for community right now?
Yeah, definitely. Like Anna was saying, check up on your friends too, like texting, Instagram, Facebook. If you do that, I don't know how many people do. You can Zoom call. I've done that with a couple. Dan, yes, I know. I've Zoom called with a couple groups of friends. That was a lot of fun. I've also seen people go get lunch together, but since they didn't, you know, necessarily want to sit at the same table because that's a little bit too close, you could bring it out to your car. And then park your car as far enough away, and then sit in the trunk and have the trunk open, and you can still talk to each other.
Tailgate.
And you don't go to like a park to get a, you know, two different tables. You can just use your own car.
Genius, genius. Naomi, what have you seen students do to fight for community?
I mean, I've seen like a lot of people, like, you know what they're saying, like FaceTiming and being on call and stuff like that. And like just hanging out with each other through that, so that we're staying connected and we're still with each other. And even though it's not the same thing, we still see each other.
So good. Hunter, do you have any ideas, or even like, how do you engage with your friends around God and community right now? What tools have you used?
This, what we're doing right now, is a really big tool. But what I do is, because I have two perspectives, because most of quarantine I didn't have my license, and so I couldn't go anywhere. So what I would do is I would just like go on Snapchat and talk to people I haven't talked to in months and just start talking with them. But I just got my license a couple days ago, so now I can go hang out with my friends and kind of do what you were saying, kind of just do a tailgate thing. Me and my friends went golfing today, but we had masks on and stuff, so I can do that type of stuff now.
Yeah,
but if you can't do that, you can just go on Snapchat and talk to people.
Snapchat, Instagram, we have a Discord server you can chat on. Hunter, you helped set that up. There's the YouTube show in the chats. This is community. Like, it is community right now. Like, what we're doing, having this discussion, the dialogue that's happening in the chats next to us, like, the power of technology to keep us connected, the ability to meet in person on Sundays again to help keep us connected. All of this is new tools, new ideas to help fight for community. So students, take advantage of all of those things. There'll be links in the description of ways to sign up for small groups, the Instagram link, the Discord link. There'll be ways for you to get connected virtually, digitally, and in person every week now. It's incredible. Anna, what do you think? What do you think? What are you going
to
say?
I wanted to say that for all the students that are considering going to small group but haven't yet, that you should really do it, because it's been probably the biggest thing that got me connected in the church, and it was one of my biggest supports, especially in the beginning of COVID when I didn't have anyone like on a Zoom call to talk to. Every week we would have a small group meeting, and it was great.
Yeah, so. I'm pretty sure most of you students are either in or have been in a small group in your time as student ministry, and it's just such a great place for connection. Join a small group. Anyway.
Do it.
So this Sunday, this morning, we talk about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. In their story, they were Israelites who were taken into captivity by Babylonians. So one day, they were just hanging out, and then a nation destroyed their nation. It destroyed where they went to hang out. It destroyed their everyday routines. It impacted who they talked to, when they talked to, how they talked to their friends. And when we looked at this story, Stephen, Mark, and everyone this morning, like, it just becomes so clear. Like, they experienced a COVID-esque experience where life was normal, something happened, life changed forever. And they had to shift their mindset. They had to shift their thought. And the choices they made in that season dictated the outcome. And as we all know, the outcome is when there is an idol for them to bow down to, they chose to stand up in that moment, get thrown into a fiery furnace. God showed up and was there with them because they chose to stand for what was healthy for them. And I would love to hear your thoughts on, what does this story teach you about the mindset and the choices of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego?
Well, I think to start off with, just my biggest takeaway was faith. Like, what in the world? Major faith. And it also shows that if you're a Christian, you're not gonna be like apart from oppression or hard times, and it's still gonna affect you, but you have someone backing you up. Like, all these people were bowing down to this idol, and then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were like, no, I've got God behind me, I'm not gonna do it. And it just shows major faith.
Yes, so good. It's great thought. Joel, what did you take away from the story?
Yeah, I definitely saw that kind of thing. But also, like, one thing that hit me was their perspective. Is they could have spent the whole time, like, looking down, looking at their problems, looking inwards towards themselves, and seeing, oh, everything's wrong. You know, I just got taken into captivity. You know, now there's a giant idol, and I, you know, what am I supposed to do? But instead, they had their mindset on things above, like I think Paul says in one of his letters, and that really guided them. It helped them make the right decisions, even though it did end up getting them thrown in a fiery furnace. But even in that situation, they weren't looking down at their fiery furnace. They were looking up at God,
yeah,
trusting that he was going to keep them safe in there. And like with the whole COVID thing, I've had days where I spent the whole day looking down at That's my good. Problems. And like, you know, I don't get to hang out with anybody. I'm so sad for me. And then I've had days where I just spent most of the day looking up at God and seeing the things that he's been doing, seeing the things that he is showing me in his word. And the way those 2 days went was so different.
That's incredible, and it's such a powerful truth. Thank you for sharing that. Naomi, let's come to you and let you talk around this idea of what you took away from the story.
A big part that I always take away from the story every time I hear it is, like, not giving in to, like, peer pressure, because especially being, like, a teenager in high school, we have so many things around us that influence us. And now that we have, like, social media, Instagram, Snapchat, things like that, we're so influenced by the things that we see or the things that we think we should be. And so when we have God with us, we're able to say, I know who I am and I know who I trust, and I have faith that he's going to help me in the hard times that I have, and that, like, he'll guide me through whatever I need.
It's powerful. Love it. Hunter, last thoughts about this question of what you took away from the story.
Something I always have seen from the story is how we might not see it, but God, like, in that situation, they could literally see God with them. And it makes sense. You always have a God with you no matter what. You always have him, like, right next to you, watching you and looking out for you, but you might not always see it. So it's good to have a situation where they could see it, so you can understand that he is always with you. You might just not see it all the time.
Man, students in the comments, drop these: faith, perspective, dealing with peer pressure, and God is with you. Those are four powerful takeaways from the stories that, as you read it, Daniel chapters 1, 2, and 3. Keep them in your heart, keep them in your mind, and really take a look at it. Thank you for sharing. Let's end our time. Anna, you have one more thought, then we're going
to
end
this. Yes, I wanted to say that I forgot to add that the fact that they said that God will deliver us from this fire and from you, but if he doesn't, we still don't. Mm-hmm. We still don't worship you or your idol.
And it showed their faith. It showed how they stood up to the peer pressure. It showed their belief that God was going to be with them. And again, that perspective that Joel talked about of being looking up, of looking to the real goal and not at the tragedy in front of them, or the pain in front of them, or the fear in front of them. And in this COVID season, students, that is the power. That is the truth. That is the goodness of the gospel. If you look at God, you're going to be able to stand up to peer pressure. You're going to be able to have the faith to believe God's going to be with you always. And that if you keep focused on that, next is going to be healthy. Next is going to be good. Joel, would you mind closing with a word of prayer?
Yeah, sure. Father God, I thank you for this opportunity we have to sort of come together in this community over this show, Lord. I thank you for each of these other students and Dan that are here with me. Lord, I thank you for the wisdom that you've given to each of them. I pray that you would continue to bring us together, Lord, over this, Lord, that we would not fall away, and that we would continue to look up to you to find what we should truly believe in. In your son's holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Imagine one morning waking up and nothing, and I mean nothing, will ever be the same in your life. For Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that's exactly what happened. Three Hebrew boys woken from their sleep one morning, told to get up on their feet and travel to a land that they didn't even know. They get there and they don't know where they are. They don't know where their families are. They're separated from their parents. They don't know what they're saying. There's a different language obviously being spoken. They don't know what they're eating. They don't even know if they can eat what they're eating. They don't know who they worship. They don't worship God. Do they worship God? They have gods, but what God? Who God? Your God? Will we get in trouble? Will we die? Will we survive? It's crazy to think how much life can change in the blink of an eye, but it's nothing too different from what we've experienced with COVID-19. But just like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, you can move forward. We can move forward.
Wow. What better way to move forward than stepping into getting into community? You have an opportunity to do that. We want you to be a part of stepping into the newness that is actually in this season. I want to let you know that you're not alone. So let's go ahead and do that. You guys can text that number that's on the screen so that you can be able to stay locked in and not disconnected. All right?
Oh. It's a great way to stay connected because we're doing new things. We have Sunday morning that happened this week. We have small groups launching in 2 weeks in this show. So text that to find out how. Is there an Instagram page, Mark?
There is. Yeah, sure? There is. Students.crossroads, okay? Search that, follow it, start liking everything we do. You'll get notifications for stuff that comes up. And man, we want you also, that's a great place to connect to us. If you want to DM us there as well, have some conversations with us. Make
we
us
might
feel
be
like
doing
like
some
us.
New things on the Instagram with group messages potentially.
Yeah.
So guys, join us so you can join community. Also, subscribe to YouTube. Subscribe to YouTube. And make sure you RSVP for next Sunday's Sunday Morning Live because Wake Forest filled up this week. Filled up this week. So you need to RSVP early or you're not going to be able to join us in person.
Out.
Don't miss out. It's going to be epic. And finally, we have to say this. Share this content with someone. Ask yourself who needed to hear this conversation.
Everyone.
Copy and paste the link. Send it to them. So as we've ended the last few weeks, Mark, you've prepared and you did this for me earlier, the most beautiful dance, the most heartfelt rendition dance ever. So as the students are saying goodbye in the comments, would you mind to dance us out, if you will, from today's conversation?
Oh my God.
And Steve-On, you had a spoken word too you're going to do, right?
Oh, wait, hurry! Make stop dancing!
Oh, no. Bye.